A hearty welcome to all of you for this Sunday program, which is Creative Campus Network. So, the whole program will be carried over by Preeti and Karan Sagar. They will be taking over, they will be guiding you completely through the program. So, I'm handing it over to them.
Thank you. My name is Preeti from CSE Department, first year.
My name is Karan Sagar, first year from CSE Department.
Now, I request all the dignitaries to stand up for prayer song.
Welcome our three judges, Andrea, German Judda, Miss Vinaya, Dr. Lakshmi.
Dear students of first year, ask our classmates that this program is happening on campus. Generally, Sundays are lazy days. Start with friends, that's it. When we don't do anything, it becomes very boring. But because of this program, we are getting a chance to enjoy and to learn. All the students of first year are so happy that this program is happening and presence of faculty members makes really, really, really happy.
Let us now know about this program. In our life, many times we get more influenced by many big celebrities. Every small kid in India knows fantastic achievements of Dr. A.V.J. Abdul Kalam in design and his love for children. All the people in this audience get so much excited when they know about their role models, for example, Sachin Tendulkar, Lata Mangeshkar, etc. And as the students of engineering, many times we wonder about brilliance of Bill Gates and Steve Jobs. It's great to know about these people.
Friends, we are so much addicted to excuses. Whenever we face failure, we give some excuses that I was not well prepared, I did not have enough time, or we may blame someone else to cover our excuse. But today, I am going to talk about a person who has defeated a deadly disease, cancer, just to move forward in the direction of his dream. Yes, I am talking about Yuvraj Singh. Yes, Yuvraj Singh was born in Punjab, in Jat Singh family to Yuvraj Singh, who was a former cricket player. Yuvraj in his childhood was not at all interested in cricket. He used to skate and play tennis. And he was quite good at both of them. He had won under 14 skating championship. So, but Yuvraj's father hated skating. He used to say that if you want to be a man, then start playing cricket. So, it was Yuvraj's father who forced him to play cricket. In the beginning of his career, Yuvraj was rejected by Navjot Singh Sidhu, another Punjab cricket legend, because he can't find any skill in Yuvraj to move forward in the direction of cricket. So, it hurted Yuvraj the most. Because he was not that successful as a cricketer, so he wanted his son to fulfill his dream. So, they went home, he transformed his garden into a cricket pitch. There they used to practice day and night, and it was his father's hard work that Yuvi was selected for under 14 spot. He was then promoted to under 19, and there he scored 137 against Himachal Pradesh, and he was unbeaten. He performed brilliantly in Kuch Bihar Trophy against Bihar in Jamshedpur. Bihar was bowled out for 357, and then Yuvi started the inning for Punjab, and he scored 358 runs. And he scored 358 runs, and he was the leading run scorer of the match. In the 2000 Under-19 Cricket World Cup, which was led by Mohammad Gam, Yumi was the man of the tournament for his brilliant all-rounding performance. And this was the match which gave him a breakthrough in international cricket. And who can forget Yumi's 6 sixes in a row against Stuart Broad. And it was one of the famous Test Match series when India was chasing 326 in reply to England 325. India was all down and out for 144 for 5. But then two young batsmen, Yumi and Kaif, restarted playing freely. Then Navjot Singh Sidhu, who once ejected Yuvraj, applauded him by saying, "It's not the size of the dog in a fight, but it's the size of fight in the dog." In 2011 World Cup, Yumi was having scored 362 runs, which include 1 century, 4 half century, 4 man of the match title, and he was also the man of the tournament. And while in the process of doing so, he became the only cricketer to score 300 plus runs, and he took 15 wickets in a single season of World Cup. We all know life is not so same, it's not so easy always. It's full of ups and downs. When Yumi was in the peak of his career, he suffered from a disease called cancer. We all know that he was playing a match against West Indies, then he started vomiting and spitting blood from his mouth. But he didn't quit because he knew his team needed him. He played there and he moved his team to the next level. Doctor diagnosed him and they were not confirmed, but they told him he was suffering from cancer. Yumi ignored it because he knew that he wanted to move forward in the direction of his dream. Then he went for a tour to England with a cancer in him. When he came from the tour, it was confirmed that he is having a cancer in between his heart and left leg. He was not able to breathe. He went through 3 sessions of chemotherapy, and trust me, it's not easy to get out of it. It's something inside you that is killing you and taking everything from inside. He was discharged from the hospital, he fought against cancer and he defeated him. He was selected in Indian squad, and this time not only batted well, but he bowled really well. In the year 2014, RCB purchased him at the cost of 14 crore, and in the year 2015, Delhi Daredevils purchased him at the cost of 16 crore, which was an all-time high in the auction of IPL history. In this year 2016, Sunrisers Hyderabad purchased him at the cost of 7 crore, and they won their first IPL season. Yumi was conferred with Arjun Award in the year 2012, and he was given Padma Shri in the year 2014. He is the man who taught the world that if you got a dream, then you have to protect it. It was all because of hard work, dedication and determination that he was transformed from human to a hero. He had inspired the entire world and he is inspiring the entire generation, and he will do so for the many next generation. At last, I want to thank you. Thank you all. Thank you.
What is that one great thing from Yuvraj's life that you would like to have? In your own self?
Yes, sir. That fight, he didn't give up. Then he suffered from cancer, he didn't give up that time. Yeah. He's a real fighter that we can, so that I want that fighting quality in me.
Yeah. Excellent. So, friends, actually, Pratik is also a winner in some way, because imagine there are lots of people among your friends, among the faculty members who may be 50, 60 years old. I don't think they might have addressed even a gathering of 10 people also. So for the first time, a first year student is standing in front of 150 students and talking so confidently. Is he not a winner? I request our Vice Chancellor to present the prize is assured for everyone. Okay?
Good morning, my dear grandchildren. Really, I am happy. Today, Pratik Pandey is a opening batsman and a I congratulate you. Please keep it up. And the international cricket will be on the best.
I'm from IT department, first year. Well, everyone in this auditorium can speak and talk and walk. But do you guys know about Stephen Hawking? That he can't move, walk, and not even talk. And he's paralyzed because he had a disease called motor neuron disease, which had paralyzed him over years. And he invented a wheelchair by himself. Do you know that his father, Frank Hawkins, was a medical researcher at the Oxford University, and his mother, Isabel Franklin, was a secretary. Well, that's true. Actually, Stephen Hawking is an English theoretical physicist, an author and a cosmologist, and a director at the Theoretical Research of Cosmology. Well, I am very much inspired about him because he never gave up in his life. Even when he got to know that he had a disease, he never gave up. He had hope and he had belief that he can do it. And he got many awards for his research and discoveries, like Albert Einstein Award, Albert Award, and Fundamental Physics Award. And recently, last year in 2015, he got BPPA Foundation Frontiers of Knowledge Award. Well, I have read one of his theses called The Origin of the Universe. And I have some interesting facts that I would like to share with you all. First is that, do you know that the Boshongo people of Africa believe that in the beginning there was darkness, water, and the god Mumba? God Mumba? And they believe that when in one day Mumba got a stomachache and with the pain he vomited up the sun, the stars and the moon and the animals and then finally the man. The question what Stephen Hawking asked was, in the beginning what happened? What was the origin that world started? The obvious question comes in our mind, what happened before the beginning? What was God doing before he started, before he made the world? Did he prepare hell for such people who are asking questions, such kind of questions? Well, I would like to conclude by saying that let it run through our minds the question that I've asked you guys, and I want you to go through it and read about it. It's a very interesting thing. And I have inspired in that I should never give up, and as well as I want you guys to go through the problems that occurs in your life and face it. And let us solve it by yourself. Thank you.
She was the only, I don't want to use it in a different manner, she was the only lady participant who came forward saying that I'll be the first one to talk. So big round of applause. Sharana, what do you learn from Stephen Hawking?
Never give up in life.
Never give up in life. See, how lucky you people are. How lucky all of us are. We have got completely functional hands, legs, completely functional body, and what kind of optimal utilization we are putting there. And just look at this guy who is completely wheelchair bound, he can't even speak, he can't even do some of the normal things we should take for granted. So he's a great inspiration. Do you know there is a movie on him which was recently released? Theory of Everything. Excellent. So can I request the Vice Chancellor for this wonderful talk? A certificate and an assured price. Right?
This Cyberswan from CSE department post here. I think everyone who Steve Jobs. He was the chairman of Apple. But at present, the CEO is Tim Cook. I'm inspired of Steve Jobs one thing. So I'm asking for my story. The full name of Steve Jobs is Steve Paul Jobs. He was born on February 24 in 1995. Okay? He completed his graduation in California, in Mountain View. Then he got to read a college in for 2 years, but he was a veteran in his college of one semester. He came to India to learn his Eastern languages. Then there was a member with a Stephen Wolfgang. He is trying to build a small computer. Then Stephen was fascinated by him, by marketing a computer. Then they both formed a company. Stephen was named Apple because in his summer he was taking Apple, so he named it Apple. And he's the one who got a man of decade. And in 2003, the doctor named it as he has a cancer, but when he has a cancer, he can't even give it to his employees or public. But at last, until August 24. And then when he had a treatment to remove his cancer from his pancreas, Then the emperor's reputed him like a ring, but he had not even taken. Until he still fighted for his apple. And finally he done it. An apple was once won. 2000 apple falls for one, and finally apple I bought for once and 2010. Thank you.
Do you have an apple bag with you? Okay, would you like to have one?
I have to edit some hard work. I have to edit my.
Yeah, so that's
it. But one thing about it is look at the people very naturally.
I love Steve Jobs because he makes them more phones. In future, I didn't become Steve Jobs.
Yeah. You're very nervous, right? You're nervous? Your hands are shivering. Chetru Kalvantre? Good. So, if somebody is nervous and if hands and legs are shivering, if the knees are buckling, it's very, very common. Okay? So, it's not about putting up an artificial show. So, don't worry about what happens for the very first time. It's like riding a bicycle. It's like jumping into the swimming pool for the very first time. You see it. Okay? So it's not about talking into perfection, it's about being natural. Okay, now with this kind of introduction, I want to ask now Sai sir, talk one sentence about Steve Jobs, whichever you want, confidently and loudly.
The one thing I learned in Steve Jobs is, sir, when he had a cancer, he did not even reveal to his employees or public until last August.
Yeah, do you see an improved Sai sir? Yeah, that's what you will be. Okay. Not
everyone. I'm not getting you. I want full energy. Good morning.
Good morning.
This is what I want. Okay, hello everyone. I'm going to tell you about. So, what do you think when you hear a word hero? I'm asking you, huh? Okay, hero can be. Yes, actually, anyone or anything. A hero can be a superstar or athlete or a cancer survivor also. A hero can be a tall, short, fat or skinny also. A hero is a person that you can look up to. Or such a good example, my hero is... This is Jackie Chan. He was born in Hong Kong 4th April 1954. His parents called him Chan Kong San. He moved to Australia. 1 year later, Jackie Chan returned to Hong Kong and joined a Chinese opera school. He studied there at this course 10 years. He worked. Next slide. Jackie worked hard. Where he worked hard, opera school. His teacher, Yun Sung Young, saw that he was very strong and skillful. He asked Jackie Chan to join in Seven Little Fortunes. And these are Seven Little Fortunes with Sam Yeong and Yu Biu. And Jackie Chan's first comedy movie was Dungeon Master. He acted in this as a funny role but skillful kung fu hero. This film was successful in Hong Kong but not in the America. And in 1980s, Jackie Chan successfully made film in both Hong Kong and America, but still few people know him. And in 1996, he made Rumble in the Bronx. This film was very popular in America. Today, everyone loves Jackie Chan. Is it or not?
Yes.
Yes. So this is at the age of 2, 4, 18, 23, and now still ever being for 60s. Thank you.
Do you know that there is one karate club in our university? Huh? You know karate club? No? You should join it. Right? Friends, I just want to present one special guest today who is here to teach Mandarin to us. Please come. Any challenge which we don't know?
No, I know nothing about him. Sorry.
Yeah.
Because I don't know.
Okay. So there are lots of clubs. One of the clubs which is very popular in our place is Karate Club. So with this kind of inspiration which you gave, I'm sure some people will join the Kung Fu Club. Right?
I hope so.
Sir, can I repeat?
Now he is a football player at his childhood. He is a great goalkeeper for his district team. His coach suggested him to go for cricket. Then you can prove yourself there. He worked as a TD in Kharagpur railway station for 2001 to 2003 for 3 years because he is a middle family. After coming into cricket, Dhoni ranked number one batsman in 2005 to 2006. Next he is all time greatest batsman for this era. Next he is a no doubt best batsman. He's the only leader of Team India who won all three World Cups. Dhoni is the only Indian captain who won 100 matches all over the countries. Now I want to tell about the brilliance of Dhoni. Dhoni played his first match against Sri Lanka and he played his last match against Australia. Dhoni debuted in ODI first match against Australia. Dhoni is the only one captain among the world with all three major tournaments collected by ICC, like One Day World Cup in 2011, T20 World Cup in 2007, and Champions Trophy in 2013. He is the only captain to win IPL Champions Trophy for twice, who never come into the crease for us. Next. Dhoni is created as ICC Player of the Year for two. Indian Army is registered with the UN Colonel in 2011. What the lessons we have learned? Now I want to tell a small incident I want to share with you. In 2014, July 21st, I think so, India vs South Africa match is going on. While South Africa batting, the Duplessis is the only batsman to score a century, is going on like a rocket. One of the shots that was born 60 is dead and he is damaged and fell off on the ground. Then Dhoni came and with a smile on his face asked him to Duplessis, "Are you free right now?" Then Duplessis replied with a huge smile that there is no more argument to that why you are the best captain in the world. We have seen different shots in cricket arena, but we love only one shot is helicopter, who is where Dhoni is father of it. And Dhoni has recorded a fastest stumping in 0.09 seconds. If I want to say about Dhoni, it's not enough. Full day or full year. So I want to conclude it now. So thank you for giving this golden opportunity.
Each one of you present here. Having heard a couple of presentations prior to mine, I'm also motivated to share a few words about my inspiration. This is Professor Dr. Nirmala Prasad. She was my mentor for nearly half my life. Yes. Old adage goes, Mata Pita Guru Deva. And she's true to that universal truth. And she is her reflection of what she sees in her students. What I am today is because of her. And she dared to dream, and she made sure that dream was transferred to all her students to make a difference in thousands of lives. Expect this. Do not go where the path may lead, go where there is no path and leave a trail. And this is the philosophy that I learned from Dr. Nirmala Prasad, as said by Ralph Emerson. And I'm very happy to find a very vibrant atmosphere at Wayton University with an amazing leadership. And we are a team that is bound to leave no stone unturned. Having said that, Vaidyanath University is stepping into its next step. We have started the School of Media Technology and Communication. We have three departments, BSc Visual Communication, BSc Multimedia, and BSc Electronic Media. So this year we will have two vibrant departments taking their first toddler steps, that's Visual Communication and Multimedia. The following year we will have Electronic Media as well. So what's special about Visual Communication and Multimedia? One, we have the best infrastructure in any of the private colleges. We have the largest television studio, only second to Anna University, which attends their studios by the central government of India. So we can take pride in the fact that ours is the largest television studio. And we have some of the most creative papers which will be open to you guys to specialize in as university lectures down the line. A journey of 1,000 miles was begun with a single step, and now we are in the first step. So what is that first step that we would do from our end? The first thing is, let's celebrate the creativity that we share amongst us, the energy that we have amongst us. Thanks to our Pro Vice Chancellor and the management for an amazing Sunday opportunity to the Creativity Campus Connect program. And we are looking forward to celebrating cinema.
Received 39 hours. among Padma Awards is Padma Bhushan Award on 26 November 2000 and Padma Bhushan Award on 26 November 2008 and Leadership Award on year 2010. Thank you.
Look at these people.
So you have made a beautiful attempt to talk about the Ragnarok. Okay? So fundamental thing is you should be natural. Okay. I will say three sentences and look at these people and talk about it. Ratan Tata is a handsome person. Ratan Tata makes beautiful cars. I like Ratan Tata. Talk loudly, look at these people.
Ratan Tata is a beautiful person. And don't marry.
Important. Look at the audience, talk in a natural manner, right? So it's not a must that, see fundamentally what I want when you are in the first year, this is not compulsory that you should stay put, especially people who are in the last row in case they are getting disgruntled, they are becoming restless, you can just step out. Vice Chancellor, Director, Academics and Register, all of them are here to give you permission to go out, okay? So whoever is not interested in listening to the fun-filled environment, they can step out. Don't talk among yourselves. This is a great environment where your friends are talking, celebrate it. So this guy has made a beautiful presentation about a great person called Ratan Tata. I don't know how many of you people know, when Ratan Tata wanted to make one sub-1 lakh car in India, many people thought he's a fool. And when he wanted to fabricate it and develop it completely with the indigenous sources and market, and people thought that Tata Motors is going to sink. But he proved all the people wrong. He proved that all the detractors were baseless in their assumptions. And now, whenever we look at an Indica, whenever we look at Nano, how proud you feel, right? Wherever you go, especially when you go out of the country to places like UK and Sri Lanka, you can see many Tata cars on the roads. Right? So thanks a lot for talking about Ratan Tata. And next time, look at the audience and come. Okay? So.
Good morning, you one and all. This is Suman of CSE department, first year. Yes. We can know many persons, but a person whose name has the meaning, PH, who is the name of the money, I mean the gateway of the money. The gateway of the money is reaches to the name of the Bill Gates. Yes. Bill Gates. He was born in city, Washington, October 28, 1955. He is the son of Mr. William Henry Gates and Mary Maxwell Gates. He has one elder sister, Christy, and one younger sister, Libby. He married Marina French in Hawaii on January 1, 1994. He had three children, Jennifer Catherine and Rory John and Harley Foy. Education. Yes. Gates finally graduated from Harvard University and then left to Microsoft. Okay. Gates and Paul Allen co-founded the Microsoft, which became the world's largest PC, which they are using. So many members, but the main vision of the Microsoft was every computer on the desk and every computer Microsoft was to install. Microsoft was to install every computer. I mean, a computer on the desk, a software is in the system. Yes, this is the main vision of Microsoft. He and Bill Gates and Paul Allen co-founded the Microsoft. Yes. Ruling of Microsoft. Yes. During his career at the Microsoft, Gates held the positions of CEO, Chairman, as well as Chief Software Architect. Yes. Yes. He has received many awards, I mean Padma Bhushan and Silver Buffalo Award. The main famous award is Bambi Millennium Award, Satellite Special Achievement Award. He had not only, he had donated a lot of people, he had donated many systems and the internet connectivity, the schools, and he made them proud. He had given a lot of money for building of a software in after when he has graduated from Harvard University, he had given a lot of money to Stanford University to build a computer institute. Not only these, there are so many donations are there, but yes, coming to the property, yes, within, according to the 2007 key public records, which is the total assessed value of the property is $125 billion. First person, who is the richest person in the world, having among the top 10. But within, in 2009 to 2010, there was a sudden fall in the property with the, then later he dominates the Carlos Slim, who was the Mexican telecommunication CEO. Then he becomes the richest person in the world. Yes. Gates last full-time day was at the Microsoft boss, June 27, 2008. Then after that, he had taken a new post as technology advisor to the newly appointed CEO, Satya Nadella. Yes. I am a follower of Bill Gates. So our main problem I had dedicated to all the youth, all engineers, is that is strong determination as the center and hard work as the radius drives until to your life. This makes every youth as a proud. Thank you.
Do you all like this confidence? Yeah. So you're a lot of positives. Your body language is good, your confidence is good, your diction is good. What is very important is you don't have to struggle by trying to buy hack and by trying to reproduce everything. Okay? So take a posture. Look at the audience. Whenever you want to take a pass, look at the slide. There's no problem. For example, show me the slide where the awards are shown. Show me the slide of when awards are shown. Okay. Next one, think. For example, you are talking about this award. Think. Look at this award. Look at this slide and tell them. Friends, you know that Bill Gates won lots of awards, including Padma Bhushan Award. And I don't remember all the awards which he has won, but there are so many that I don't even remember. Say that. Okay, say that. Look at the slide.
Yes. Yes, my dear friends, you know many awards, but including the Padma Bhushan is a famous award of him.
So, that's enough. Do you know why he got Padma Bhushan Award? Anybody can make a mess. How come an American got Padma Bhushan Award, which is generally given to the most famous achievers from India? Why did Bill Gates get special prize in case somebody can say that? Yeah.
Every year in India adopt a village.
Any other thing? Okay, yeah?
He donated half of his wealth to
Indian. Okay, there is one distinct reason. He set up a foundation called Gates Melinda Foundation. Okay, in his name and the name after his wife. So, he has gone on a mission to remove lots of diseases in India, including malaria prevention, TB prevention, etc. So in recognition of the outstanding work which Gates has done for the betterment of the health among our villages, he got this Padma Bhushan. Padma Bhushan, is it? Padma Bhushan, Padma Bhushan in 2000. Sir, can you kindly give it?
Karina.
teammates have a cute little AR Rahman. Before, after his born, before his name was AS Dilip Kumar. When he was sister so ill, son had him. For AR Rahman, his friend suggested to change to Islam. So he changed the name from Dilip Kumar to AR Rahman. You know, when I was in 9, I was playing outdoor games and many mischievous things. But AR Rahman played a tune on piano and further his father complete a full song. Unfortunately, his father was died when he was just 9 years old. Then his family rented out the equipment for income, family income. And he got scholarship at Trinity College of London at Oxford University, where he studied Western class music and he got degree in music. In 1991, Maniratnam gave chance to his film to compose a song music for his film. It was Roja, it was blockbuster hit. There his journey starts. Some of the movies which Rahman composed and using. Rahman was told many music lovers, but Saira Banu, who stole the Mozart of Madras, who is none other than Rahman. Heart troubled songs, he awarded Padma Bhushan from ex-president Prabha Patil, and also from many more awards like IFA awards, 2 German awards, 15 Filmfare awards in South. He also entered into the Limca Booker record as Indian of the Year for the contribution of the Indian music. And also he got Oscar and many more. I will be tired in saying the list. And he was member of, he was ambassador of the, appointed as ambassador of the Stock Keeping Partnership. He also supported for the people, women, children like this. Thank you for giving this opportunity.
Okay. Very nice, but fundamentally there should be continuity for the story. So it's not a must that you have to separate the story into separate segments and create a path between them. So Rahman was born. He was a prodigy as a kid. He lost his father when he was a kid. Then he got into movies at a very young age. He became a sensation with Roja. Then he continued to work in Tamil movies, Telugu movies. Then he went on to become the producer of Chartbusters in Hindi. Then he went all over the world, okay? So you can create a continuous story and don't create passes, right? And do you know when does Rahman compose in a regular session, what is the time at which Rahman composes? Anybody can say, what is the most favorite time of Rahman for composing the music? I'll be very happy if somebody says, because I am also a great follower of Rahman. Huh? 9? 8:45 to 3:45 is very late time space. Not Rahman's time. I'm talking about Rahman's time. Honestly, no one knows. He composes his music between 2 to 5 in the early morning. Between 2 to 5, he gets up. So somebody asked Rajamouli the other day, would you like to have Rahman for your future movies as a music director? Then Rajamouli said it's impossible. Then he was stunned. Why? Because Rahman gets up at 2 o'clock and finishes his work by 5. I get up at 5 o'clock and start working from 5. So it's impossible for us to work together. If you want, you can see the YouTube clipping. It's there. Okay? So, nice work, sir.
I was very inspired about Mother Teresa because all of you know that no woman can do like that. And we know that she is the only woman who got Padma Shri from India, who came from Yugoslavia. Okay. She was born on 1910 August 27th, and she was born as Agnes. She was born as Agnes. She decided to be a nun at the age of 12 because when she was moving to a school and on the road there she saw the old man was fell down on the road. Nobody is bothering about him and just all our nobody is bothering about him, all are doing his homework. But she want to help him. Then at last she helped him and she went to the school late and she got a punishment from the teacher and they asked the boys why you are late. Then she said, I helped the old man, but they did not believe. Then she got a punishment of whole period and she thought she was not attentive to the classes. And she thought about the old man and the poor people who were there. At last, so at the age of 12, she decided to be a, she was very faith in God and humanity. At the age of 18, she came to Kolkata to help the people who were suffering leprosy. Working with the poor. And in 1948, she got the Indian citizenship. In 1948, she got Indian citizenship and opened her school in Motilal to serve the homeless and the poor. On September 10, 1964, she got the calling to work with the poor. And she became the missionary and she got a permission from the government. Missionaries of Sardi. She started with 13 women and now there are 4,000 adult people who was working under the Mother Teresa Trust. The great thing is, she built a building with the 5 rupees. She built a building at 5 rupees in the town. It is very great thing and she built many buildings for the poor. Opens in 1952, Nirmala Hotel for the dying. And for people who are lost of children and she helped in many places and very good. sake of her. She got her right two times and she was there in 1997 on September 5th. She got many awards like Padma Shri Award and we know that she is the only woman who came from the other country to India and who helped to the India poor people and thank you all for giving this opportunity and she is the only
and I am going to talk about the father of rocket science. Do you people know who was the father of rocket science? Anyone? You might know. He was a German only. Yeah. He is a Wernher von Braun. It's Wernher von Braun. The dreamer of the space and the engineer of the war is the biography of a man who opened the doors to the space. He was born on 23rd March 1912 in a noble family. He was the second of three children and he got a telescope as a gift from his mother when he got confirmation in Lutheran Church. So he got very much inspired and he was influenced in by that telescope and he got interested in astronomy. He got very much interested in astronomy. He was very inspired by two guys, Max and Fritz, who have made a speed record using a rocket propelled car. He also attached some fire wagons to his toy car and detonated it into a protostrate, which led him into a custody also. Let's come to education. So he was sent to a boarding school. Like most of us or some of us, he was also not good at physics and mathematics. One of his professors gave him a book known as Why the Rocket into the Planetary Space. Reading that, he got very much influenced and he studied very hard in physics and mathematics and got some interest in space travel. In his graduation level, he got a chance to work under Wheeling, who was working on liquid propelled rockets. So he got a chance and in his early exposure, he found out that a lot has to be done in this field. So he went for the post-graduation and also did a PhD in physics. Let's come to his career. He formally, officially applied for the Nazi membership and became a civilian of German army. Under German army, he developed a rocket named as V2. But he got to know that Germany is not going to win over the Allied forces. So he, along with some 1500 of scientists, surrendered to US army. V2 rocket. V2 rocket is Vengeance 2. It was basically a rocket which was designed for taking revenge of the insult. Wernher von Braun was a guy who was basically focused on space travel. But because of the Hitler power and some Nazi power, all the rights were taken from him and Hitler attacked using this V2 rocket on London as well as Paris. Life in US. Under a program named Operation Paperclip, he was taken under the US Army and worked on missile program. Only after 10 years, he got to assemble in NASA and worked over there as a director. He made many projects over there and all through his life, he was focused on one mission, that was manned mission to the Mars. So some of his rockets and other things were developed there. Explorer 1. Explorer 1 was the first space shuttle which was sent out of the Earth and it gave many possibilities for sending a human also to another planet. Now let's come to Saturn V. Do you guys know what Saturn V is? Anyone? It was a rocket which took Neil Armstrong and other crew members to the moon. It was a three-stage rocket Initially, it was having a speed of 3 km per second. When the first stage got de-attached, it attained a speed of 7 km per second. Only after getting the second stage detached, it attained a speed of 11.2 km and get out of the field of gravitational pull of the Earth. This was the first manned mission to the moon. Thank you.
Aeronautics. What do you want the person in aeronautics?
I want to be a
designer. Very good. Excellent. So he is the only one you have seen. He talked about a core engineering subject. I wish this gentleman goes on to become a very good rocket engineer. Sure? Yes. Now I am also a participant. The only thing is I will talk about a couple of biographies for 2 minutes. But VC will not give me any prize because there is nothing for me. I just wanted to talk about people. These days, I would like to really.